Hey lovelies, welcome back to my channel. If you are new to my channel, I hope you enjoy this video. I also hope that you subscribe. Make sure you turn on your notifications so you don't miss any videos. So today's video, I am using Gershon's Builder Gel and Kiara Sky's Jelly Tips in Long Coffin. I am starting off with the Kiara Sky Jelly Tips in Long Coffin, their prep and their primer. Gershon's base coat and Gershon's builder gel in clear. So I have already pushed back my cuticles and removed the cuticle from the nail plate, and I'm going in with one coat of the prep, letting that dry, and then going in with two coats of the primer and letting that dry between coats and before I apply any product to my nails. At the end of this video, I will go through all the products I used again, so just continue watching if you want that complete list at the end of the video. So Kiara Sky, I did do a full video on Kiara Sky applying the tips, unboxing, and doing a fill, and those videos will be linked above. I just wanted to try the system with this Gershon Builder Gel and their base coat. So I just wanted to try it with Gershon's products. So I'm going in with a thin layer of the base coat, and I'm going to cure that for 60 seconds in my UV LED lamp. And I also did do an unboxing of the Gershon products, which I will link in the cards above. So those videos will be scattered throughout this video, so you can click on those links when you're done watching this video. For a very detailed application of the jelly tips, you can reference that first video. So I've already etched inside of the tip that I'm going to use, and I'm just putting some builder gel in that well, just making sure it covers all areas. I'm gonna place that on my nail, and when you put the pressure on the nail, all the air bubbles will come out. So I'm just doing that there. And then I'm gonna flash cure that in the Kiara Sky lamp for about 15 to 20 seconds. I'm just looking at the nail here, making sure that the sidewalls are attached properly and there are no air bubbles. So once I feel that that nail has been attached on top, then I just kind of rotate the nail to the other side from where that lamp, the light's not hitting, and then it's flash cured. Once I'm done applying all the tips, I will cure the entire hand in my regular lamp for 60 seconds. I don't cure each one for 60 seconds because I kind of want just to flash cure it, get it on, and then just keep the process moving. So when you're doing your own nails, you can't work the other hand, obviously, while you're curing. So you kind of want to flash cure and just keep on moving. So I do like this builder gel so far. I did not experience very much heat spikes with this builder gel. It was very, very slight, the heat spike that I did experience. So it was nothing too major. I wouldn't adjust anything about it. Like the nails just got a little bit warm, but for the most part there were no heat spikes with this builder gel. So what I'm going to do in this video is I'm going to just apply the tips with the builder gel, but I'm going to add some builder gel on top. If you've watched my previous videos, I have stated that I would not wear the Kiara Sky tips without adding structure to them. I was watching Long Hair Pretty Nails when she did a fill on her Kiara Sky tips, and she said that initially when she wore them, she didn't put any additional structure to the nail or strength to the nail. So she just felt like it was wearing your natural nails at this length. For me, I couldn't survive 3 weeks like that. I need strength to the nails. I use my hands way too much. We've already discussed that in previous videos. So after I'm applying the tips, I'm going to blend them into the natural nail, because I'm not going all the way to my cuticle with these tips, because these tips don't fit my cuticles perfectly. You can shape them, but I don't want to do that. So I'm just placing the tips just a little bit above my cuticle area, making sure that it fits sidewall to sidewall. And then when I'm doing the application of the other builder gel, I'll worry about that then. But at the end of the day, there's different ways to use these tips. You don't have to just place it right at your cuticle area. If it does not fit, you can place it a little bit above your cuticle area, or you can just file that to match the shape of your cuticle. The full coverage tips, it is a little bit more work than just putting on the regular tips or even sculpting a nail. But for me, I like it because it helps me with the structure of my nail, and it helps me a lot with the shaping of my nail. You still have to be aware of your shaping and structure when you're adding product on top, but it's kind of like a guide for me. So it's helping me out a lot. So here you see me going in with this cone bit. It's a medium grit. My e-file is on about a 3 or a 4. And I'm just cleaning up the sidewalls, making sure that's blended, and then making sure my cuticle area is blended. And then I'm going to, I don't like saying rough up the surface. I like to say etch the surface of the nail, so the product that I am going to apply after adheres to the nail. When you're applying product on these smooth, shiny surfaces, they do have a tendency to pull away and lift. So that's why you wanna etch the surface of the nail. You don't wanna like gouge out the nail or anything like that. Just little scratches in the nail so the product has something to stick to. So that is what I did there. And after I've done that, this my ring finger is crooked. I redid that finger twice, and both times it came out crooked. So don't be in the comments talking about my finger's crooked. I know, I tried to fix it. I did exactly the same thing. So I'm not gonna try and fix it again. We're just gonna roll with it. So now I'm applying another layer of the base coat. This is not needed because the surface is already etched, but I just wanted to do it, so I did it. I added some base coat. And I'm gonna cure that for 60 seconds, and then I'm gonna start applying the builder gel. And in the unboxing video, I did state how the builder gel, it has the applicator tip, which makes it easier, and applying it on the nail, it is easier. The one thing that I did notice about this gel is it does not move. So when you have a gel that does not slide around the nail, it doesn't self-level as well. So for me, I don't care. I'll take the gel not moving over self-leveling any day, because I did not have to worry about my cuticles getting flooded or my sidewalls getting flooded. The gel stayed where I put it. The first two nails I'm showing you, I did not use a slip layer. The pinky nail, I used a slip layer. And I did that because I wanted to see if there was a difference in applying the gel with this tip. And I would suggest do the slip layer. You will see me doing that on the pinky nail. So just hang out for a while and watch. So with this gel not self-leveling as much, it's because it's a thicker gel. Runnier gels self-level easier or more. So you are gonna have to really make sure that your filing is done to remove any lumps or bumps from the nail. And I'm just going in, applying the gel, looking at the finger from different angles, seeing if I need to apply more gel. And I will say this goes on a little bit thicker than you think. So once I cured it and filed it, I was like, oh, these nails are a little bit thicker than I thought. So you can just keep in mind a little bit goes a long way with this builder gel. I don't want to say that it expands, because scientifically, I don't know if it does, but it kind of felt like it expanded like a sponge after I cured it. But that's so not scientific. So I turned my nail upside down, seeing if it would self-level a little bit, and it really didn't. I am going in with my brush just to kind of make sure I have all of the gel where I need it. I did go around my sidewalls and my cuticle areas, making sure those areas were covered but not flooded with the brush. So this brush that comes in the kit really does come in handy, or you can use a detailer brush or any other gel brush that you already have if you're using a different product. But I really do like this builder gel. It is easy to work with. I have worked with gel before, and this is one of the easier gels that I've worked with. I attribute that to the tube and the applicator tip, especially this being a thicker gel. So this is how I applied it. I started with a little bead and then kind of moved that close to the cuticle and sidewall, but not all the way. There's still a little bit of gap there, and that's just to allow, if the gel was going to move, then that would have allowed that. However, this gel really doesn't move very much. Also, because I'm gonna go in and just get that as clean as possible with the brush after I get the gel applied to the entire nail. So after I've gotten all that gel where it needs to be, I just squeeze a little bit more out of the tube and then just use the applicator tip to kind of move the gel around. And you kind of want to have a light touch, because if your touch isn't light, you're really just gonna, you're dragging it and leaving like a trail of like emptiness. I can't really explain it, but you want to just kind of move on top of the gel, not through the gel. If you move through the gel, you're gonna have gaps. If you move kind of like on top of it, then you're moving it. I hope that makes sense. If it doesn't, I'll try and explain it in the comments if you don't get what I'm saying. So each layer of this, I did cure for 60 seconds. I think what I did was flash cure. I edited out most of my curing of the video. So I think what I did was flash cure for a few seconds and then went on to the next nail. When I did my right hand, I was able to do two nails at a time without the gel moving around and without the gel flooding the cuticles. So here I'm doing a slip layer, and I pushed out too much gel to do a slip layer. So I just brushed that everywhere where I want the gel to go, and then just put the excess gel on the tip. So the thought behind the slip layer is it's kind of like a guide for the gel to move where you want it to go. So it helps it move to that place. And I did have an easier time with the pinky once I did the slip layer. And then when I did my right hand, I did a slip layer on all of those nails as well. So I would strongly suggest just putting a little small drop, brushing that out on the nail, and then going in with adding the builder gel. And once you have squeezed out, don't squeeze out the gel for the whole nail. Just do it like in sections, unless you're really, really comfortable with how much to use and with gel application. But I think this would be good for the first time you're using gel, because of the applicator tip. It does help a lot. Also, I am linking the Amazon link for this kit below, and then Gershon's social media as well. As far as the Kiara Sky products I'm using, I will link those down below as well. I will link their website down below, and you could go on their website and look for those kits. So here I'm just making sure that I have enough gel on the tip, on the sidewall, cuticle, nothing's flooded. I did flip it over thinking it would self-level, and that really didn't help this at all, which is fine. I'd rather have a thicker gel that doesn't move and self-level than a gel that self-levels and floods my cuticles and my sidewalls. So, which is another reason why I think it is friendly to a beginner, because you don't have to worry about those two other things. So you can see here, I really do have to do some filing, and really quickly, I will show you how I do the filing of this product after I remove the sticky layer. So in the initial video, the unboxing video, I briefly talked about how easy this was to file. I did do it on a swatch stick, but now I'm actually doing it on myself. This was really easy to shape. This was really easy to file. It did have lumps and bumps, so I was able to smooth all of that out with my hand file. I only went in with my e-file around my sidewalls and cuticles, and you guys have seen me do this before. For the most part, on my gel, on my poly gel products, I do hand file and then just use the e-file to seal in that cuticle area and those sidewalls. This is the file that came in the kit. It is a good file. However, my preference is the boomerang files. I think that's what they're called. I do like that other shape better because I am able to get a little bit closer to my cuticle area just because of the way that it's shaped. Yes, so I am going to show you, I think I only kept in two nails. So I'm gonna show you how I did the filing on that using the e-file. And again, I think the e-file may have been, it wasn't any faster than a 5. So I did use the same comb bit you saw before. I did turn it up just a little bit faster because I had a little bit more product covering my natural nail. So I am gonna show you my filing here and I will be back shortly to talk about my nail design. I file the nails, buff the nails, clean off all the excess dust, and I'm going in with this white by Azure Beauty. I'll give the number at the end, and I'm going in with Beatles in 247. I don't remember what collection this is from off the top of my head. So I'm gonna do marble nail, surprise, surprise. I love me a marble, I love me a quartz nail, I love a swirl nail. I think it's because it's artwork that's really, really easy to do. So I just put some lines of gel polish on the nail. And this brush, I am going in, I'm making sure the brush is damp with acetone. And I'm just kind of removing the excess gel polish, smearing it in certain places, and just making sure I'm creating those veins or those lines, but also leaving a little bit of it smeared in as well. And this is a really easy nail design. You can't really go wrong with it because there is no like exact way the marble should look. You can kind of have an idea, but you can mess up or you could think that you've messed up and it still comes out really, really pretty. So I did that, cured that for, I think I flash cured it for about 10 seconds after I got the lines to where I wanted them. And then I just went in with some of this glitter and just did the exact same thing. I just put a little bit on and just moved it around to where I wanted it to go, using the acetone on the brush. So I'm gonna do that on one more nail. And I did, after I did the gold, I cured that for 60 seconds. So I'm gonna show you this design on one more nail, and then I will be back to talk to you in a sec. I'm adding the top coat here, and I'm going in with a little bit thicker of a layer of top coat just because there's some texture to the nail from the nail design. And I'm gonna flip the nail over, let that self-level, let that even it out. And all that, the white stuff underneath my nail is the one downfall of these gel tips that I don't like. When you get alcohol on there, it gets all milky and cloudy. I really, really hate that. You can avoid that by just putting a layer of top coat underneath that. But yeah, I really hate that. It looks disgusting. But after I washed my hands and cleaned my nails with my nail brush, it did go away. So I'm just going in with the top coat. This top coat is nice. It cures very smooth. It's a non-white top coat, but you know, sometimes they have that slight tackiness. This doesn't have it. This is not high odor. So I did like how this applied. So you guys have already seen all my thoughts on the Kiara Sky stuff, so check out those other videos. As far as this builder gel kit goes, I really like it and I think I'm gonna get a lot of use out of it. This color is showing up a little bit more red than what it really is. It's kind of like a peachy pinkish coral, but it shows up a little bit more red on camera, especially in my other video. This video is a little bit more true to color, but it's a little bit lighter in person. So what I used was the Kiara Sky Long Coffin Tips, their prep and their primer. I use Gershon's Base and Top Coat. I use their Builder Gel in color 10 and clear. I also used Azure White, it's GG01, and then I use Beatles in 247. And this is the design I came up with. I like it aside from that crooked nail, but I tried to fix it twice and it didn't work out. So here's my design. I hope that you guys check out the links I leave down below for Gershon. Thank you so much for watching. I do appreciate you spending your time with me. Please make sure that you like this video, you leave a comment, and please also make sure that you're subscribed to my channel with the notifications on. And I will see you guys all back here soon for another video. Thank you so much for watching.